Hi. One thing I always miss from the character animator is the ability to switch arms automatically. For example, look at my arm. Wrist turns, elbow turns, pretty much everything is turning. And we can do all that with character animator as well. But we need to press a bunch of buttons and knobs and sliders to make it work properly, and we kind of have to do it at the same time. Recently, I found a way to do all that automatically with Openstage Control software. This allows us to use just one knob to turn the elbow, and all the art will be switched automatically. Today we will review how you can make one for yourself or use the one that I made. There are a couple of preparation steps required before we start. If you never heard of the Openstage Control software, you will need to refer to this video and set it up first. Additionally, you will need to have your puppet rigged in a certain way, so refer to the Character Animator video as well. Links for everything below. After you're done with preparations, you can start with the Adobe Character Animator. Go to the scene, find your transform behavior that uses your elbow, and grab the rotation control out of it. Find the minimum and the maximum values for rotations to match the starting and the ending positions that you see on the screen. If you have a different starting position, you will have to adjust the code later. The only thing that is necessary today is an elbow, but you can also add a whole bunch of things, including the wrist and shoulder. You also need to make sure that you created all the different swap sets with different wrists, with different shoulders, and with different forearms, because they all will be swapped based on your arm movement. Specifically, we can see that elbow can look left, can look right, and can be hidden because the arm is looking to the center. When you have all your swap sets prepared, make sure to assign MIDI notes to them. I use one for the in, two for the side, and three for the out, and they are same throughout. Yo. Now we can open the Openstage Control software. I refer to the GitHub link below to download the same files that I'm gonna use now. As you can see, when I move the knob now, my arm is swapping, so I never have a weird elbow. How do we do it? Let's go to the edit mode and click on the elbow knob. We can open the scripting tab, and we will need to go through a little bit of a code because it's the scripting part that is handling all the heavy weighting around sending MIDI values to swap our wrists and body parts. So what is going on in the script itself? First, we just create a variable, which is just a place where we store the note that we will send at the end. After that, we just go through a series of if statements to analyze the current elbow value and assign the proper value to the note. After this step, we'll basically have the correct value for the note that we want to send. And the last thing that we need to do is to check if we already did it, because we don't want to consistently send the note to swap the wrist to the character animator. It will lead to the flickering, and we want to do it once every time we enter the new zone. All that allows us to control the arm, and it just never looks weird, and in general much more convincing. You can also expand these controls with forearm scaling on the x-axis. This will allow us to bring the wrist closer to the elbow, and in general have some nicer controls. We can also switch the wrist between the outside and closer to the center, which would be the mid wrist. We also have the separate controls for the shoulders, for the wrist. We can switch arms between the top and the bottom, so we can be in front and behind the head or behind the body. We can switch our mouse between the happy, neutral, and sad expression. We have the full set of eyebrows that we can set between. And also when we bring the arm to the center, we can control the position in a more granular manner, and we can also drag it diagonally, because when we're gonna rig it with an arm control, the common scenario would be when the arm is just transferring from inside to outside through the center. And in this case, diagonal is kind of a more natural way to just go about it without the fully customizable control on every single case. We can also position our character on the screen. We have five different positions pre-rigged. We can scale the complete character or some parts of the body. We can rotate the character, and we can put the granular control or where the character is on the rotation, both on X and Y axis. And the last thing that I added is the rotation between left, right, and 3/4. We'll keep working on that and see what other improvement could be done. I'm very happy with how it looks so far, and it allows us to have a bunch of automations right now at no cost and pretty much no effort. Let me know if you have any ideas, or if I'm missing something here, or I can go into more details around some specific area. Coming up with the closing part of the videos is super easy. You just say cheers.